Reliance Commercial Finance presents India SME Forum 2012. Find out the secrets of success in a series of seminars exclusively for smart entrepreneurs. Join India's biggest SME initiative to boost your business and celebrate SME achievers with India SME 100 Award.
Here, it's great to be here. It's great to be with people like you who are entrepreneurs. I've always wanted to be one, but after many years, took the decision last year to become one, after having worked for companies for most of my life. The two words on this slide. Now, I want you to focus on these two words, customer and intimacy. Together you understand what they mean, but let's for a few moments spend time on each word. Customer. I use this word very carefully, customer, not consumer. Consumer is what Unilever's or a Pepsi will use. Customer is what people like you would use. Each customer is important. A consumer is a faceless entity. A customer is somebody you know. Not necessarily by name, but you know him. You know his shape, likes, dislikes, what he's bought, what he's likely to buy. You know enough about that person. Intimacy, as Shri just talked about, is like wedding, getting married. You need to be intimate about your customer. If you're not intimate about your customer, he's a consumer. He's faceless, he's anonymous, he doesn't really know what you want, you don't know what he wants. And like Stone Age man, every morning you get up, get out of your cave, go hunting, kill something, and eat that night. If you don't hunt in the morning, you don't eat at night. But the world has changed. And that's both good news and bad news. So let's start with the bad news. This is what 1,700 chief marketing officers have said in a survey last year. 1,700 chief marketing officers across the world, across 20 industries in 64 countries, of very large companies and not so very large companies. They're not sleeping very well, ladies and gentlemen. They're troubled because a chief marketing officer's job used to be approximately 4 to 5 years, 10 years ago. Today, it's down to 24 months. If they don't deliver, they die. And there's a very good reason. Shrini talked about it. Mistakes are becoming very expensive. You cannot afford to make mistakes. The good news, however, is you're not inheriting any of the bad learnings from the past. As SMEs, you have the ability to craft your future, your destiny, using today's paradigm rather than what existed in the 1950s and the 1960s. Let's just focus on these four points. And these are mind-boggling points. Explosion of data. Eric Schmidt, who's the CEO of Google, made a statement which, in 2010, which woke up technologists across the world. He said, from the dawn of origin of man as Homo sapiens, till 2003, the amount and quantum of data created by mankind gets recreated every 48 hours today. Every 2 days, you create the same amount of data and knowledge, or information, sorry, which it took man ever since we became human beings till 2003. Every 2 days. That is the quantum of data you're dealing with. It's available right now. This session is being recorded. The photographs which are being taken, the speech which is recording, the words I've written, all is getting captured somewhere. Number two, this devil called social media, which is by some extents the second largest or the third largest country in the world after China and India. What do you do with it? What was your neighborhood old wives club which used to talk about the new soap brand or the new new detergent brand 30 years ago is now available on Facebook and Twitter. It's getting into languages. It's no longer a problem for me to communicate with my cousin anywhere in the world. In next door, how bad or how good are the services. Proliferation of channels and devices. Srini talked about television. When I started my career, there was one channel, Doordarshan. And that's it. It was black and white. In my career lifetime, I don't know how many channels exist. I don't know how many print television, newspapers and magazines exist. Forget the internet. Number of devices, whether it's touch, feel, you're surrounded by them. And most critically for me is the shifting consumer demographics. You know, all these people talk about India as a young population. With my gray hair, I don't know what a 20-year-old man or a woman wants. I think I know, based on my past experience. But my past experience is no longer relevant to their past experience. They have grown up in a different world. They have grown up in a different society. They have grown up with different educational needs. Their worldview is different. And I'm struggling with that. So these are the challenges which everybody across the world is confronted with. The reality is that these challenges, which was this survey done in 2011, had been predicted by a very smart professor at Kellogg School of Marketing, Professor Sahni, some ten years ago, where he said, on the left is what marketing, the way it was done, transactional. You bought something, you sold something, and that is the relationship that existed. That's the end of the relationship. Over a period of time, because of certain needs, especially in the business-to-business segment, you got into what is called relationship marketing. A lot of it does exist even today. And lastly, what is required to deal with this new world is conversational marketing. You need to involve the customer in your decision-making of products and services, and therefore thereby build your brands. The reality, unfortunately, for some people, is that most of the work which is being done in this country is still into the transactional space. The good news for you is that if you start right, you can leapfrog directly into the right-hand side of the table without learning how to do the left-hand side of the table necessarily. Close to 20 years ago, and this is not newfangled, close to 20 years ago, I didn't have a cell phone. 20 years ago, I did not have internet. 20 years ago, we didn't have any of the stuff we are talking about today. But there was one bright man. His name was Jeff Bezos. He set up a company called Amazon, where internet was still something which was really in the labs. I got my first email account in 1996. I got my first cell phone in 1997. So, you know, 3-4 years before a lot of us in India got it, and a lot of this was not even present in the US, this man set up Amazon. Amazon's fundamental principle, and most people make a mistake about this, it's not a retailer. That's not how they want to describe themselves. They're not a technology company. That's not how they want to describe themselves. He said this famously once. He says, I stay one step ahead of my customer. I just know when, what he wants. I need to know that 30 nanoseconds before he knows it. And if I do that well enough, I can deliver value to my customers. Now, when you sign on to an Amazon account, they know exactly what you bought, what you're likely to buy, etc., etc., etc. That's old story. Done, dusted. Guess what Amazon has done? They're probably the only people who have used this medium effectively. It's a thing, the second largest country, the third largest country in the world, Facebook. Amazon introduced the concept of social shopping through a Facebook interface. Very simple, not very expensive. They're able to estimate, based on your profile, what would you read, what would you listen to, and what would you watch, and accordingly give you solutions around. Now, this is a solution which Amazon built. This is not necessarily a solution which is relevant to some of us in this room. However, the principles and the core of the solution, which is know thy customer, know your customer exceedingly well, build your systems, build your enterprise systems, build your IT infrastructure based on one fundamental premise. It must understand your customer. That's our dharma, that's our karma. If we don't service the customer, we shouldn't be sitting in this room. And we have no reason. The better you service the customer, I promise you that the cost of servicing the customer may be high in the first year, but it reduces your cost of sales progressively every year, and you should benchmark yourself. Every year, you should turn around and say, how much can I reduce my cost of marketing to customers? How much business should I get from my existing customers? How much business should I get from my friends of my customers? and challenge yourself and bring that and build your systems and processes and your data warehouses accordingly. Sounds complicated, but reality is that thanks to people like Microsoft, etc., and cloud computing, these things are not very expensive now. Through cloud computing, you can work on pay-per-use model, transaction models, very simple to do, very simple to implement, not very difficult. Having said all this, there is one word of caution, and that is based on some my own personal experience and what Einstein said, not everything that can be counted counts, and not everything that counts can be counted. Do not become so overwhelmed with data that, you know, it becomes the way and means of your life, but learn from it, automate your marketing systems, automate your sales process, let the system learn from itself, and what you'll find is that you'd be able to focus on more important things rather than chasing up some minor issues which confront us every day of the week. Thank you. Sorry? Okay. What I do is, simply put, is I work with clients, identify what the needs are, and build systems like this for them. Or if they already have certain systems, I integrate those systems and make them more efficient in their use. Does that help you understand? So I look at CRM, any form of data, loyalty, digital, and integrate those pieces for clients. Digital anything. It could be digital marketing, it could be digital sales, it could be digital conversations, anything to do with the word digital. But fundamentally, it's data. I mean, you know, we're all talking about data here. It's about using data for marketing. The thing with marketing with my clients is that marketing is the last function in organization which gets automated. You know, sales gets automated, manufacturing gets automated, finance gets automated, everything gets automated. Marketing does not get automated. Marketing is always like that craft project work. You take one project at a time. But, you know, resources are limited. We all can't hire strong marketing people all the time, you know, and we are running across 300 things every day. What you need to do is automate some of that. Let the system take decisions. It's called rules-based. That's what I do. So, thank you.